Good evening, everyone. I'm George Mallet.
And I'm Stephanie Gorin. People ousted from their homes by flooding who are starting to pick up the pieces, well, they need help, and they need it fast.
Question is, will they get that help? We go now to News Channel 5's Mia Moran. She's live in our Vermont newsroom with an update. Mia.
Well, they started early this morning in the town of Jeffersonville, then made their way to Cambridge, two of the towns most affected when the Lamoille River crested its banks. The FEMA team came armed with cameras and clipboards.
Pleased to meet you, Jack.
Walking from house to house, examining the wreckage from flooding inside and out. The rushing water ripped through downtown Jeffersonville and Cambridge, forcing some to evacuate.
The area that we're standing in had about 2 to 3 feet of water over the top of it. So, and today you wouldn't even know that there had been a flood through here.
Most people are back in their homes now, but the damage is done.
Some of the damage is, to individual homes, carpeting and walls and some potential mold issues. So we want to, make sure that we identify all that and get it cleaned up properly so we don't have hazards down the road.
FEMA will decide if it's severe enough for a disaster declaration, guaranteeing grant money to help get individuals and businesses back on their feet.
It would be for people that have been out of their house, haven't been able to get back into their house, they've been staying in hotels and that type of thing. There are grants available that come directly from FEMA for housing assistance that would maybe pay for the hotels.
According to state officials, Lamoille County took the biggest hit, racking up more than $1 million in damage. Next in line, Washington County at $674,000. And not far behind, Grand Isle County with nearly $611,000 in damage.
Let's see, it was 4 feet of water in 10 hours.
The list is long, and it could be several weeks before FEMA makes a decision.
What we'll have to do is we'll wait until we've looked at all the damage we can before we actually sit down and crunch numbers.
Until then, residents will have to do what they can on their own. Now, FEMA teams also walked around Orleans County today and will take a tour of Chittenden, Grand Isle, and Washington counties the rest of this week. In the Vermont newsroom, Mia Moran, News Channel 5. Back to you.